Welcome back to another ACS 64 Kid video. Today I will be doing a rallying part 2. Here we have one of the cars that I missed in the last episode. So we'll get started right off the bat here. Now this car did pretty good the first time I tried it on this track. The second time I tried it, it went terribly wrong. And this one is going better than the second round. Not quite as good as the first time though. But I'm not gonna complain. Hairpin, get it sliding. Not too much power here, else we're gonna flip. It's not enough power. Alright. I'm gonna redo that. Over and perfect. Oh no. That's bad. Come on, line up right there. You go. That is what I'm talking about. Oh, come on. You were so close to making it. You're stuck again. To the last stretch, last hop, and some on the brakes. Alright, next is the Ibishi Pessima Coupe, which is another one I missed in the last episode. This one actually has engine sounds. Now this one is pretty slidey, but I think it did about as good as the other Pessima. The first time I tried it, in fact, it did even better. Probably because it doesn't have those big wheels. But it still has a limited amount of power to it. Well, except for that. Oh, we've lost a wheel. Oh, it's a bad crash. And we slide in. Into a good drift, hits the inside a little bit there, does the two bumps, oh, hits the wall, no biggie though, as it comes into the finish. Not bad. Alright, next is the, Hirochi Prasu. When I tested this one, it did a little bit more than I intended. If you guys remember or have watched the East Coast USA map review, then you remember this thing outdid itself. It has just way too much power. This thing around the track without crashing. Especially if you want to get a good time. It must be because this thing really likes to roll over. See, look at that air. See if it can do a good air out. Inside. What's our next one? The champ of the track. when I tested this one, it worked like a dream. This car is like the chosen car for this. I mean, look how good it's doing. It's staying in the middle of the track. That was my fault. But it goes over these nice. Has minimal damage upon landing. And it's just like the perfect car. It digs in. Oh, it's rolling now. Goes over the jump well. We'll see. Which will be a D-Series. And we will choose this thing. E15 Off-Road. Alright, let's go. This thing is a bit more slidey, but when I tested it, it still looked pretty good. Come on, E15, big. Not digging. Dig. Man, this thing is really sliding. But the best part about it is that it takes the jumps really good. Like, it doesn't have any bumpers to damage. It just doesn't dig. Oh, that was a high, but see, perfectly fine. Oh, there's too much pull. Max it out. Get on the jump. Get over the suspension. Oh, now it's digging. Good girl. Oh, there goes an axle. Come on, dig, boyo. Good finish. It was also a quick run. The next car will be the Hopper. And we'll do the custom because the off-road didn't go fast enough. A little bit faster. Now, obviously, SUVs weren't really meant for rallying. It's more of a saloon slash hatchback thing. Because these SUVs and trucks, they just don't grip. And then, they do that more often. But that's kind of just my driving. But they do take these jumps really good. Which kind of makes... I mean, this one isn't really rally. Is it like... Maybe like a derby rally or a rally cross? I don't know. But he's going into the... He's coming up to the big jump. He's got a pole on it, so we set it there. He's going for the big jump. He's good around the corners. He doesn't have all that much speed, but he still does it. Goes over the suspension course. Whips around the corner. Good grip. And not bad for a finish. Ooh, good brakes too. Alright, the next car on our list is the Roamer. And we'll do the Adventure, which during testing forms did not grip very well and is nowhere near fast. But it's still an okay car. See what I mean about grip? It's just barely avoiding the walls. really can't let off the throttle. Anyways, look it around the corner. Go over that jump. Here it comes for the big one. Come on. Less than 7 miles an hour. Oh, that's not good. Direction is broken. Or drive shaft. Alright. Well, the one respawn, he goes over the suspension, over the hill, the small hill, and then goes to the final stretch. And stops. Alright. To the next car, which is an automation car. And this is the last one I ended up testing, but from my perspective, it is not all that great. It's very bad at digging into the corners. Well, maybe not there. I mean, it can do a little bit, but see right here, straight into a wall, even without the throttle. Which is when max grip comes into play for most cars. It's also not very good at taking these jumps. Come on, aye. Oh, there's a flip. But luckily on automation cars, they don't get damaged very easily. But also this thing is terribly slow. I'm not even gonna hit this jump with it. Well, I guess we made it. Over the suspension course. Into the second to last turn. Over the two hills. Last turn hits the wall. And over the jump with a slightly unexpected ending. Oh, the brakes are bad on this. So yeah, not the greatest car. Now, it's Land Rover that it's copying is a fairly good car. I can't take that orange. Alright, the next truck is after a T-Rex Raptor. Oh, wait, no. That doesn't make sense. Raptor. After it spawns in. I have hope for this one. Oh, yes. Very pleasant. Oh, come on. Keep your grip, boyo. You have viewers to impress. Does this thing have no traction at all? Oh. Oh, wow. Also, one thing that not many cars, if any cars have, is that brake light up there on the top of the window also counts as a reverse light. I have never seen that in a car before. Except for this. Oh, over the suspension nicely. But does it grip? For a flying finish and goes way past the line. Alright. Stop there. Next car is going to be the. Who is next? None. Well, we'll go with the Golf. Even though it's in yellow. This thing has no power. Come on, that's some Pee Wee City car. Is this a GTI version? Doesn't do a bad job at gripping, though. Oh yeah, that's nice. Not too much grip, but not too much Oh, that was loud. Anyways, he goes into a jump. Maybe somewhere in sounds around the hairpin. Not exactly where you're supposed to do the hairpin. The jump. Comes in for the jump. Can he make it? He's got about 60 kilometers. That is not gonna make it. Well, anyways, that is going to complete it for this video. If you liked what you saw, then, and you want more Beam and G on the channel, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment, please. Notification, we need 10 subscribers. Sorry about that.